Are you looking for peace of mind at your doorstep? Look no further. With the Blink Video Doorbell, your home's entrance is always within your control. Check out the link in the video description to learn more and get your Blink Video Doorbell on Amazon. Your home is in your hands.
A frequent flyer has hit out at Delta after she claimed the airline lost her ticket number and forced her to fork over thousands more dollars on a new flight. Tori Elise frequently boasts her day-to-day life online with her over 140,000 TikTok followers. Most recently, the Arizona-based hairdresser took a break from her usual beauty content to air her frustrations with Delta and warn other travelers after she endured a chaotic and awful experience with the airline that left her in a fit of tears. In a viral video, which has so far amassed over 672,000 views, Tori said that the travel company acted like she made her ticket up when she was trying to get back to Phoenix following a trip to Greece. She claimed that despite having originally purchased a business class seat, which cost her thousands and thousands, she had to buy another ticket to get home. Tori detailed her frustrating experience in a 9-minute video shared to TikTok. She explained that things went awry when she and her husband stood up to board their flight home. When I go to give them my confirmation number, which, mind you, is in my phone, I have all of my confirmations. I even got the emails that said it's time to check in for your flight. Everything is set in stone from my end, Tori explained. But, instead of welcoming her onto the plane, Delta staff claimed that she didn't have a ticket for the flight, even though they were able to locate her husband's ticket without issue. She said that airline staff started to look a little funky and confused before asking her for another form of ticket number or separate confirmation. Recalling what the gate agent said to her, she explained, "We can see that you reserved your seat, we have your name here, but we can't find your ticket number." Tori claimed that she and her husband were left standing at the desk for over an hour while the employee tried to get to the bottom of the issue. "I'm starting to panic because it is 30 to 40 minutes before our flight leaves," she admitted. Tori claimed that airline staff said it was due to miscommunication on the back end. "We see your name, but we don't have a ticket number for you, and if we don't have a ticket number for you, we can't get you on the flight." "I'm like, well, our flight takes off in 45 minutes and I paid for this flight. My husband and I are flying together, like his flight, and everything was fine. I need you guys to get me on this flight, like this is pretty crazy." She said that time continued ebbing away, and with 25 minutes to go before takeoff, staff urged, "Ma'am, if you want to make this flight, you are going to have to pay for a new one. It's the only way." Left with no other choice, she decided to book a ticket for the flight, adding, "It takes a lot for me to cry. I'm not a crier, but I literally started crying because they made me pay thousands of dollars to get on this flight." Tori and her husband made it to the plane with minutes to spare, with the couple expecting to get the funds returned when they get back to the U.S. She made it through the 11-hour flight from Athens to Atlanta, but ran into yet more troubles on the second leg of the journey from Atlanta to Phoenix. The frustrated flyer said she had been put on a separate flight to her husband and then had issues when trying to board there too. It turned out that her ticket had been assigned to a different passenger, meaning that she wasn't able to scan it during boarding. The staff at the airport were like, "How did you get this ticket? You're not on this flight, you're on the next flight," literally acting like I made this ticket up. I'm like, "You guys, I had this printed by your staff, someone that works for your airline. I didn't just come here and make this up, and I'm trying to get on a flight. This is what was printed and given to me." After the complicated disaster, she was able to board the plane on standby, however, she never got her money back. At the end of the clip, she added, "I know a lot of people like Delta Airlines and haven't had problems before, but I have never experienced anything more chaotic, awful, than this. Not only am I thousands and thousands of dollars out of pocket, but the way that the whole situation was handled was absolutely horrible torture, you guys." People flooded the comments section and expressed their shock at the situation.